ecco il tempo, che t'offesa, ma la vela, la vela, la fa, la vela, la fa, ogni tempo.
Bienvenidos, welcome to the Opera Orlando's 5th anniversary party live from here, the red carpet. I'm your host, Luis Artemio Mercado. I proudly serve as a board member for Opera Orlando, but some may recognize me as the morning news anchor for Univision Orlando. I'm on the location here at the beautiful and historic Casa Feliz Mansion of Winter Park, where in less than 30 minutes, we will celebrate 5 years of yours and my favorite opera company with some amazing singers, including my favorite diva, Cubana Laura León, plus some special guest appearances. I know I cannot wait, and I'm so happy you all have joined me. I'm going to try to grab some of those wonderful singers and see if they are ready to go for the big party. But first, in case that you don't know, our silent auction only goes until 2:15 p.m. and then all bids are off, literally. So place your bids. I know I need to check my bids on a couple of items that I look too good to pass up. More about that soon. They are telling me in my imaginary ear pace that it's time to cut to the highlight reel. Yeah, of course, the whole reason we are here. Hard to believe it. It has been already 5 years of Opera Orlando and a wide array of performances and productions that it has been from boisterous, beginning from Star Trek Mozart to Cowboys singer at the Cheyenne Salon. Wow, so fun to relive those moments. I can still hear my friend Javier Abreu singing those high C's in Cinderella 3 seasons ago. And speaking about high notes, I'm standing here in the artist entrance hoping we may catch some of our wonderful opera singers before we get this thing started. And look who's here, the diva, Laura León.
It's so good to see you.
Thank you. Thank you. You too.
Thank you.
Hey, sorry that I'm going to, you know, like, steal you for a few moments, unos minutos nada más. But, you know, like, can you let me know what are you going to, you know, like, to sing? Because I remember that you have a really great performance because you were one of the 4 heroines in Tales of Hoffmann.
Definitely. Well, for today, we're going to be singing Olympias Dawson. You know that is a must. We're also going to have some amazing duets and a big finale, but I cannot tell you anything, so my lips are sealed.
I really appreciate that she woke up really early this morning to be this with me this week also. And I put her also to sing there. Hey, I want you to, you know, like, say something to your fans that are watching you right now. Any message, special message to them that they are, you know, like, really happy to see you here in this event today.
Of course, I would love to. I just want to say, hola, mis queridos. I love you all so much. I am so grateful for your continuous support and for this wonderful company. I mean, I couldn't be any happier to be back here. And I wanna say thank you, thank you, thank you for tuning in. And if you can, and just can be gracious and keep donating and keep supporting and keep the arts alive. And now I better run because I have to go see Maestro to run a couple numbers. But it's so
thank
nice
you.
To
it
see
was so
you.
Nice to see you too.
Bye-bye-bye.
She say it, please donate. So good to see Laura, and she is so right. We are so grateful for everyone watching and all of your amazing support. As I'm sure you all know that we have a matching challenge of $50,000 total of today's virtual gala. We have already raised a little of $30,000 toward the goal, and I know we can make the rest of the day away this afternoon. Plus, do you have to donate a minimum of $75 to access this big party today? I know several of you already have, and we cannot thank you enough. Truly, thank you. So many ways to be supportive and make a donation today. You can text OPERA to 91999. Let me repeat it. OPERA to 91999. You can also call, you can email, or you can go to Opera Orlando website or purchase an item from our silent auction. I have to say, there are some amazing items up for auction, including tickets for Universal Studios and a private in-home meal prepared by Chef Bob Engst. Now, this can be in person or virtual with the award-winning and extremely talented Chef Bob.
Luis!
Look who's here!
Did you say something Opa. About Chef Bob? Opa, mi amigo, how are you?
Yes, I did, and this is the man of the hour, Mr. Figaro himself,
hey,
Gabriel Preisser, Executive Director of Opera Orlando.
Luis,
welcome, Gabriel.
My friend, good to see you. Thank you so much for hosting the red carpet for us out in the rain, if you can imagine that. So good to see you. I wish I could stay and chat, but we are getting started in just about, you know, 10, 15 minutes. I did hear you say something about Chef Bob, though.
Yes, I was just mentioning how I have placed my bid on his silent auction, an in-home private chef doing a live five-course meal. I mean, come on, that's once in a lifetime.
Yeah, it sure is. I didn't know Chef Bob was doing that item for us again. That is so nice of him. Thank you, Chef Bob. Oh, actually somebody, hold on a second.
Really? Somebody's calling you?
So much crap here. Hold on a second.
You gonna answer
somebody's
it here?
Calling me. Yeah, I guess so.
Oh, okay.
It's Chef Bob calling me.
Really?
He must have been watching from home.
Maybe.
His ears must have been burning. Hey, Chef Bob. Chef Bob,
hey,
can you hear
guys.
Me?
My ears were burning. How you doing, Gabe? I was so excited. I'm sitting here and I'm watching your pre-show with Luis, and
yeah.
Luis is awesome.
He
it
is.
Was so cool that you were able to get him to do this for you. And I was remembering last year, I was remembering the awesome events that we did together, and I remember when we were doing the live auction and you surprised me with a surprise for what we were gonna do for folks for the five-course dinner. Do you remember what that surprise was? Well, I do remember because it was one of the favorite things that I did last year. And we ended up not just having an awesome dinner, but we threw a concert in someone's home. And the difference this year between now and then is that the concert's not gonna just be sung by Gabe Preisser. It's gonna be sung by Grammy Award-winning Executive Director of Opera Orlando, Gabe Preisser, which I am super excited to see again. And the food is not only going to be cooked by Chef Bob, it's going to be cooked by Chef of the Year for Florida, Chef Bob. So we both upped our game. We're super excited on my end to bring all of this to you and your folks. And I don't know, are you in? Are you excited? How are you feeling? I wanted to call in and have a conversation because I am beyond excited. How about you?
I'm always excited, but of course I'm in, totally. Those in-home concerts were a blast this past year, and it'll be so fun to do those again. I tell you what, if we get two top bidders out there, okay, I hope you guys are placing your bids right now, we can certainly provide two dinners again this year like we did last year, okay? I guess I'll just have to bring my Grammy Award with me, Luis. Well, Chef Bob, since we have you on the phone, tell us a little bit more about these private dinners.
Well, as you know, we pride ourselves on creating unique and memorable events centered around food and beverage. And what I love about this particular auction item is that we get to center that around food, beverage, and incredible music. So the person that ends up with this auction item is going to work with me personally, and we're gonna custom design what this night looks like. I don't know what the food will be, but I know it'll be served with love. I know there'll be awesomeness. I know there'll be great music. I know there will be joy. And I know that all of those things are going to end up being a really unforgettable evening for you, for me, and for the folks that we have it with. So it's like 2 o'clock. Aren't you guys like busy? It seems like, you know, you're just like hanging out with me when I think you got places to go. I'm looking forward for the show. I'm going to sit here in the outdoor kitchen. I'm going to watch it with everybody else. And I can't wait to see you guys soon. Have a great night and good luck.
Thank you so much, Chef Bob. Take care. See you later, Chef Bob. You're right. We got about 15 minutes, so we got to get into places here. Wow, that was just so nice of Chef Bob. Right, Luis?
Well, wow. Now I will need to go back to the silent option, and I may need to up my bid. What a great item. Thank you, Chef Bob, and also to you, Gabe.
Of course. You know, I'm a sucker for singing for my dinner. What can I say? Well, yeah, we are really getting close. Luis, thank you again so much for hosting this red carpet for us. And thank you all so much for tuning in. If you haven't already made your donation, only $75. You can donate now. We'll send you the private link so you can watch the watch it on YouTube, watch our fifth anniversary party. I got to get into places, my friend.
That's okay. Thank you. I will see you in my house.
Yeah,
because I'm gonna win the bid.
That's right. I'll see you. Ciao.
Thank you. Well, you hear it, folks. At a concert by Opera Orlando executive director and Grammy Award winner Gabriel Preisser to a 5-course meal by Chef Bob Engsten in your home, Howie. Now we are talking at only 20 minutes to place your bids. Silent option closes at 2:15. Well, the video crew is getting set up for the real deal. Here it is, the almost go time, and they will be broadcasting live from right here at Casa Feliz. A huge thank you to them for hosting us and to our friends at Simple Thought Productions for making all this technical magic happen. This is Luis Mercado saying adios from the red carpet. If you haven't already done so, donate $75 to access the Opera Orlando 5th anniversary party, and you will receive the private link to celebrate a wonderful 5 years. Stay safe, and thanks for joining us. Lindo dia.
Opera Orlando celebrates its 5th anniversary season with a musical extravaganza like no other. Johann Strauss II's Die Fledermaus, The Revenge of the Bat, on stage at Disney Hall. Come dressed in your party best and enjoy a night of intrigue and disguise at Prince Orlovsky's Masquerade Ball, chock full of special guests and surprise appearances. Argentinian-born maestro Jorge Parodi conducts musicians from the Orlando Philharmonic Orchestra in some of the most memorable waltzes ever composed. With Opera Orlando's artistic director Grant Preisser directing an Orlando-centric take on Strauss's comedic farce. Soprano Abigail Rethwich is the captivating Rosalinda, joined by Grammy Award-winning baritone Gabriel Preisser as her less-than-faithful husband, Eisenstein. Soprano Cree Carrico is the feisty chambermaid Adele, with a husband and wife duo of Sarah Norden and Tyler Putnam taking on the roles of Prince Orlovsky and Police Warden Frank, presented in English with English dialogue and super titles. Die Fledermaus will be a party unlike any other. Then, a remount of Opera Orlando's acclaimed production of Engelbert Humperdinck's Hansel and Gretel. Designed and directed by Grant Preisser. Sung in English and presented in the round in the intimate Alexis and Jim Pugh Theater. The production features Robyn Rocklein as everyone's favorite witch, with Gloria Palermo and Keanu Richardson as the delightfully mischievous duo Hansel and Gretel. Opera Orlando's Robyn Jensen conducts musicians from the Orlando Philharmonic Orchestra with an ensemble of members from the Opera Orlando Youth Company, bringing the Dark Forest and Gingerbread Boys and Girls to life. Bring the family and join us for this perfect holiday treat. And finally, a true Hallmark moment, the opera comes home for its last main stage production of the season, Georges Bizet's masterpiece Carmen. A grand opera for a grand hall. Mezzo-soprano Brianna Hunter, described as radiant by the New York Times and as a mesmerizing Carmen by Opera News, takes on the title role in her Orlando debut. Tenor Nathan Graner from the Sony Masterworks The American Tenors joins her as the tragic Don José. Metropolitan Opera soprano Brittany Renee Robinson returns to Orlando as Micaela, and Broadway and opera veteran Gregg Baker makes his Opera Orlando main stage debut as Zuniga. Kelly Kuo conducts musicians from the Orlando Philharmonic Orchestra, and Sarah Witzer directs this premiere production that sets the story in the politically charged Haiti of the 1960s. Sung in French with Creole-infused dialogue, be a part of history as the curtain rises on Carmen.
And as always, see you at the opera. Why, hello there. Mr. Figaro here, perpetually at your service, and I'm so happy you joined us in your tuxedo or in your PJs. Either way is fine. We are coming to you live from the beautiful and historic Casa Felice in Winter Park, which is actually going on 15 years of being open to the public. Big congrats to them. Well, I hope you have your favorite drink in hand and, of course, some yummy snacks to help celebrate the first 5 years at Opera Orlando. Seems like just yesterday that we had our boisterous beginnings back at the Mason Jar in January of 2016. Those were the days. It's been quite a busy and wild ride since then. So come, join me inside as we take a trip down memory lane. And so it began in a crowded ballroom at the Grand Bohemian Hotel, celebrating philanthropist and arts advocate Bryce West. Opera Orlando hosted its first annual gala, and then shortly thereafter, the boisterous beginnings really began with a mockumentary-esque double bill of Mozart's Impresario and Poulenc's Les Mamelles de Tiresias. Humble beginnings for sure, but after tragedy hit, Opera Orlando showed that it could make a big impact, both for the community as a whole with One Voice Orlando, and for opera lovers with a sold-out inaugural season of Don Pasquale, Among the Night Visitors, and of course, the big man on campus, Don Giovanni. And that's when the real fun began, expanding the season beyond the main stage at Dr. Phillips Center to going on the town for operas Out of This World and In Unexpected Places.
22 productions later, from a cowboy opera at Cheyenne Saloon to Mr. Figaro at Casa Feliz, what a ride it has been, and the best is yet to come.
I don't know about you, but I'm going to need some tissues after watching that. What a wonderful time it has been, and so amazing to see our growth as an organization. Many thanks to you all out there, our supporters and fans. While our live productions have had to go on hold for right now, I hope you have enjoyed our online offerings this summer, and know that we will continue to find ways to bring great music and great artists to you, even during these socially distant times. Your response and support has been amazing, and we have already raised over $30,000 for today's events. And that is more than halfway to our goal of $50,000, which is being matched by our very dear friends, Frank and Mary Daugherty.
Here's to them and their amazing generosity. I just love that picture of them right there. Now you can see right here on our high-tech
non-digital thermometer, I know, this thing is pretty amazing, how far we have already come. This thing updates automatically when you make a donation. I know, it's like Harry Potter magic. Oh wait, what's that? Now, they're telling me that we are now at 36,150, we've passed 35,000, ladies and gentlemen. Let me update this here, look how this works. It's so fun, I've been practicing all day. Let's just write that in there, 35K. Wowee, I gotta fill in the red. My goodness, you guys are already getting us closer to our goal. There we go. How's that look? Well, we'll keep checking in on this. As you guys might know, we have a silent auction going on. Place your bids right now. That will also count towards our match, towards our $50,000 goal. So check out those items via Bradley bag. I know my wife's going to bid on that. We got a private Chef Bob meal in your home. I might even throw in a concert from what I understand. Speaking of technology, you can also text to give. I know, very fun. Just text the word OPERA, O-P-E-R-A, to 91999 to donate right now. Well, we will keep you posted there throughout the event. I know we can make it to our goal of $50,000. Make sure to bid on those silent auction items. We only have a few minutes left, only 5 minutes left till the auction will be closed. Now for the fun stuff. Please help me welcome our pianist extraordinaire and someone who has been a part of Opera in Orlando for many years, Robyn Stamper. And he is going to be joined by none other than the stunning Laura León reprising her effervescent doll song from the Tales of Hoffmann.
Oh, Wow, wow. That was amazing. Thank you, Laura and Robyn, so much for joining us and treating us with that dynamite performance. Robyn, of course, has played at several of our Opera on Park concerts, past galas, and was a part of Orlando Opera back in the day, and served as artistic director for Florida Opera Theater, our predecessor. Robyn, now you actually played an Opera on Park concert with Laura. I think that was a couple seasons ago now. That was such a fun concert, guys, a real treat for us. Do you remember that?
Oh my goodness, yes. Playing for Laura is always amazing.
Likewise, working with Maestro is just great. He just, we are one when we're performing together. Truly, truly a treasure.
It's a good time.
And then, of course, Laura returned as the four heroines in Tales of Hoffmann with some amazing costumes. We have images there for you guys. What was it like, Laura, doing all of those fast costume changes from Olympia to Julieta to Antonia, and especially getting painted in all gold for Olympia?
Well, Gabe, it was actually a thrilling experience. Some of the changes were as short as 46 seconds.
Wow.
But I had an amazing team. You truly hire professionals, and I was in good hands, so I always felt great.
Oh, I'm so happy to hear that. That is amazing. Now, we want to welcome two other singers who have been featured with Opera Orlando in the past. Singing Donizetti's immortal Una Furtiva Lagrima from Elixir of Love, we will have tenor David Margulis, followed by Bizet's ever-popular Habanera from Carmen, sung by Robyn Rocklein.
Thank you.
absolutely fabulous. So great to have you, Robyn, and David back here with us. I'm going to invite David to come back in. I think you scared him off, Robyn. There he is. David, you all right? Did you get rained on out there, David?
Yeah, I did.
Now, David, you are no stranger to Donizetti, as you played Ernesto for us back in 2016 in Don Pasquale. Do you remember that? That was a while ago. Feels like just yesterday, though, right,
you
David?
Know, it does feel just like yesterday, but it was a really special production because it was the first of this new company, and just to see how far this company has come in such a short period of time really is spectacular.
Oh, thank you, David. Very kind of you. And Robyn, you were Carmen for Florida Opera Theater right before we rebranded. There you are, Carmen. Right before we rebranded to Opera Orlando. And then you came back to sing in our gala in 2018. And you will be our witch in Hansel and Gretel this season in January. I want to show everyone your very fun transformation into the witch. Here we go. Now, Robyn, tell me, will this be your first time playing the witch?
Yes, it will. I have had the great opportunity to play Hansel before.
Really?
But never the witch. I'm thrilled to be able to have a new perspective on the opera.
Yeah, exactly. Completely different perspective. Well, we are definitely looking forward to that. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll hear a little bit more from you later, I think. Now, we are so looking forward to Hansel and Gretel, and everyone's support today will go towards productions such as Hansel and Gretel, our main stage series, our Opera on the Town series. Now let's see where we are now that we've closed out the silent auction totals. Let's see where we're at now. They're telling me after the silent auction, we're at 42,000. 42,000, wow. I gotta update this little puppy here. Hold on a second. Let's get rid of that guy. Good thing I kept my marker here. 42K, ladies and gentlemen. I need some more red here. Wow, you guys are doing amazing out there. And I understand we have a $3,000 donation from Patrick and Audrey Knipe. Wow, guys, thank you so much, Patrick and Audrey. So very kind of you guys for supporting us. Well, we've got a little less than $10,000 left to go in about 30 minutes. Do you guys think we can do it? Of course, I can hear you. I can hear you from here. Of course we can. Of course we can. Well, let's go back over to Robyn Stamper in the music room with a newbie to Orlando, but a veteran to the opera and Broadway stage, Mr. Gregg Baker, singing Old Man River.
And strange.
Stunning, Gregg. Thank you so much for joining us. We loved hearing you a couple weeks ago with Robyn for Opera on Park, of course. And we'll be seeing more of you as you're creating the role of Augustus in The Secret River, the father, and also playing Zuniga and Carmen for us this season. Now, Carmen will actually be set in Haiti. Here is a little teaser to give folks at home a taste. Gregg, you excited about Carmen this season?
Yeah, I can't wait to be a part of this, Carmen. It's a fantastic idea. But I'll have to brush up on my Creole.
as will we all, my friend, for sure. Well, we are excited to be partnering with the Haitian American Chamber of Commerce for that production. It is our hope, as you all know, to bring opera to everyone, because opera really is for everyone, and to celebrate our shared humanity and legacy. Oh, it looks like I got somebody calling me. I don't know if we're able to cut to that. I'll have to see the technology guys. Maybe I'll figure that out. Let me see if I can get the... Oh, here it is. It's John Wettick, our board president. Let's see if we can cut to him, guys. What do you think? Hello, John. Can you hear me?
Hi, Gabe. And hey, thanks for taking my call. I am here in the tux, loving this fifth anniversary party. I am so moved by Gregg's beautiful song. I just had to call and help you celebrate this great 5 years that Opera Orlando has had. It has been a real privilege for me to be the board president for these last 5 years, and I am proud to serve with all the board members and the staff of Opera Orlando, and to see Opera Orlando fulfill its mission of bringing great opera to Central Florida audiences all around. And we continue, I know, to try and fulfill that mission and that goal even in these difficult times of social distancing. As I'm watching you guys at Casa Feliz, it's a great show, and it reminds me of the site-specific production we did there a couple of years ago, Barber of Seville, which was so much fun. I think really it was one of my favorite productions that we've done. And I know you were our Figaro. You're now our Grammy-winning executive director, Figaro. And I'm gonna put you on the spot.
Okay.
Out of the blue, I know. I hope maybe you have something prepared. But if you could do a number, one of Figaro's numbers from Barber of Seville, that would be fantastic. I know that we're about 10,000 short of our goal here in terms of fundraising, and I bet if you did a little of that Figaro magic, you could put us right over the top. And I will even put in $2,000. I'll pledge $2,000 of that $10,000 right now. If you can do a little something from Barber of Seville. What do you say, Gabe?
Wow, John, extremely generous. Many, many thanks to you. Of course, I love Barber of Seville, but we presented it here in English at Casa Feliz. I don't know if I remember all those lyrics in Italian.
Siete voi, siete voi, è la rosina, o che fai me sopraffino, o che volpe sopraffina, ma la prada par con me, sì, ma la prada par con me, ma la prada par con me.
Se mi senti, voglio duro per parlar, come se fosse.
Per parlar fioro sarà zitto, zitto qui in coro per parlar fioro sarà
per parlarmi bravo, bravo venga curva con prudenza io già moro di pazienza ma che carra cosa fa
egli attende qualche segno poveri del vostro affetto sol due sotto le righe di biglietto li mandate qui verrò li mandate e qui verrò li mandate qui verrò che ne dite
non vorrei
su coraggio
non saprei
sotto le righe
mi vergogno
ma di che si sa presto presto quale biglietto
un biglietto
sì, sì, un biglietto sì.
Eccolo qua
già era scritto vecchia bestia vecchia bestia il maestro faccio a lei
fortuna di uvedire io comincio
Robyn, thank you so much for letting me join you guys. You know, anytime you get to make music with two Robyns, two birds of a feather, it really is a treat.
Oh, it's a treat for us too. You know, Gabe, don't be so shy. You're going to appear with Opera Orlando this season as well.
Well, that's right. I almost forgot about that. I'll be doing Eisenstein in Die Fledermaus. I love doing that role. That'll be quite a blast. I think we have another one of those fancy commercials to show you guys.
Thank you.
very fun production. I'm happy I was cast in that. Well, let's check in and see how we are doing. Let me pull up the magic board here. Let's see. Oh, I'm hearing now that after the John Wettick donation, we are now at $47,300. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for you. That is amazing. We'll put 47K there. Just about $2,500 more to go. Look how this thing gets updated automatically. It's amazing, the magic of it all. Look at that. Had a lot. Gosh, my arm is exhausted. Well, only $2,500 away from our goal. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We really cannot thank you enough. Well, we can't finish the event, though, until we hit our goal. So I guess we'll just have to keep singing until we get there. Let's go back over to Robyn Stamper in the music room and see what he and his singers can whip up for us.
Thank you.
You gotta love some Verdi, don't you? We've had so many, we've been honored to have so many amazing singers such as David, Robyn, and Laura with us today throughout our five seasons. Some of them were kind enough to send in some videos. We put it together in a little toast video along with community members and some of our supporters. Here we go.
Hello, I'm Mark Skorka, president of Opera America, and it is an honor to greet you on your anniversary celebration from the National Opera Center here in New York City. Opera Orlando has achieved remarkable things, but one that sticks out for me was the One Voice Orlando concert back in 2017. It was a fitting tribute to the victims of the Pulse Club killings, but it was an inspiring demonstration of what the arts can do to bring a community together and to help heal after a crisis. The warmth, the love, the power of opera, of the arts, and of the community were on full display, organized brilliantly by the leaders of Opera Orlando. But Opera Orlando is not only looking back at this anniversary season, it's looking forward. It's looking forward to a world premiere of an opera, Secret River, by Stella C. Young and Mark Campbell, that will not only advance the American opera repertoire, but it will help build audiences by having programming available for families and young people. So I say congratulations. Congratulations on your anniversary.
Happy anniversary, Opera Orlando. You guys, 5 years. This is incredible. My favorite moment, wow, there are many, but my favorite moment with Opera Orlando has to be that awesome weekend of performances of the Star Trek Abduction from the Seraglio and how amazingly fun that audience was. That was just the best.
My favorite moment from the first 5 years of Opera Orlando was getting to sing the role of Cenerentola alongside one of my very dear friends, singing my prince, Javier Abreu. We had just the best time singing together. And also the costumes and makeup for that production were beautiful, and I felt like a total princess.
A very happy 5-year anniversary. I've had the pleasure of working in Orlando several times, including some fun and exciting productions of La Boheme and recently The Barber of Seville. And who can forget those ever rambunctious recitals with the three baritones? Hopefully I can see you all again very soon. Wishing you well, hope everybody's staying safe and healthy, and here's to many, many more years of success.
My favorite moments from Orlando, and that's when I was able to share the stage in La Boheme with some lifelong friends that I've known for a very long time, and also some new friends that I hope to see again very soon.
My favorite moment that I've had at Opera Orlando was when we all came together and performed for the benefit concert that we did for the victims of the Pulse nightclub shooting. And I sang Un Bel Di, and again, it's an aria that just I keep on coming back to. But it's the aria by itself has a very strong message, and again, it's that one beautiful day, right? But I remember being I was overwhelmed. I was very verklempt after singing the aria and just having seen the support and feeling the support of the audience and just the warmth. It's something incredibly special, and to see the community of Orlando come together in such a beautiful and just the outpouring of love, it was incredible. And so the only thing that came to my mind, because I wanted to show my appreciation for their appreciation for me, was to say I love you in sign language. And someone captured it on camera, and it is forever on the interwebs. And But it's a moment that I will never, ever forget, and I will always, always cherish.
I was fortunate to conduct a production of the Tales of Hofmann last season, and my favorite memory from my time in Orlando were the pre-show talks before each performance. I look forward to coming back to Orlando, it's a city that I adore, and working with Orlando Opera, which is a great company.
My favorite moment with Opera Orlando was conducting the Pagliacci Pulcinella double bill with Phantasmagoria. Not only did we have a fabulous cast of singing actors and a terrific chorus, thank you, Robyn, but we had the unique show within a show featuring Phantasmagoria. I can't wait to see what the next projects will be that come down the line from Opera Orlando in the next 5 years.
I can't believe it's been 5 years since my first performance at the Dr. Phillips Center. It was Dorabella in Così fan tutte, and such an amazing memory. And we've done so many good shows since then, like the Don Giovanni in the Frat House, and my favorite, when I got to do Barbara of Seville in the Casa Felice. Rosina is already my favorite role, and then I got to do it for you guys in that little house with the audience right there with me, feeling all of your energy. It was so exciting.
Happy anniversary to Opera Orlando. I had the pleasure of being involved pretty close to the start when I was in Don Giovanni, the college frat production. I was playing Mazzetto. But my favorite moment from my involvement in Opera Orlando was The Girl of the Golden West, where I got to play the agent from Wells Fargo, Agent Ashby. And I got to tell the Girl of the Golden West that she should really bank with us oftener. Which was like actually one funny line in an otherwise pretty serious and amazing show.
I congratulate Opera Orlando on its successful 5 years, and I drink to their continued success with great love and admiration to everyone in the community.
So congratulations on your first 5 years, and here's to many, many more.
This is my beverage of choice, so I toast to you. Happy 5th anniversary.
Congratulations.
And thank you to the audience and to the supporters of Opera Orlando, because without you, we wouldn't be here. It's impossible. What we do is impossible without your support. So thank you. Don't party too hard, Opera Orlando.
Many, many thanks to these wonderful artists for sharing those videos. Wow, to relive those memories. Thank you, guys. Somebody is calling me again on my phone. They just won't let, oh boy, it's Scott Maxwell, who was supposed to be our in-person host when we were gonna do this live at Al Fondin. And gosh, I totally forgot to call him or email him and let him know. And oh boy, he's still calling me and he wants to FaceTime. Too. Oh boy, it's gonna be awkward. I guess I have to answer. Here goes nothing.
Gay, buddy, is that you? What is going on? We set the date for the gala. I never hear from you. You ghosted me.
I know.
So I do a little research, see that we've got a new date, make my way over here to the Alphon, put on my new tux. I had it dry cleaned, by the way. Mm-hmm. The doors are locked. I can't even get in.
Oof.
Then somebody tells me that we are still doing the event, only it's online.
Yeah.
I have to make a donation to get that.
Oh, boy.
Then I find you trying to host, and not doing a very good job, if I'm going to be honest, at Casa Feliz? What the heck, man?
Well, I mean, I don't know about that last part, Scott, but I am so sorry. I totally meant to call you. I have no excuses. Will you ever forgive me?
Oh, well, let me think about this. Okay. But I've got a couple of conditions.
Okay.
First of all, my mother says I have a lovely singing voice and I'm kind of an animal on stage.
Oh.
So I'd like a role in an upcoming production in the next season.
Sure.
Second, I know you're gonna do this gala again and my sources say it's May 15th right here at the beautiful Al Fondin Inn. So I wanna be back, bub, as the host.
All right.
And finally, where are we with the goal?
Oh, of course, the gold. Thank you, Scott, like a good co-host.
Co-host?
He's always keeping me on track here. Let's see, let me get the final. Oh, really? Wow, we are now officially at $65,000 raised. Wow, we killed our goal, ladies and gentlemen. That is amazing. And we throw in The 50,000 from Frank and Mary Daugherty, that's actually $115,000 that we raised. Now that is something to celebrate.
Wow, that's amazing. It's a good thing I called in. Though, actually, Gabe, you're doing a pretty good job yourself. So on a serious note, I want to say thank you to all of the amazing donors who have helped make tonight possible. And as a matter of fact, I just happen to have a glass of champagne right here. So I'd like to propose a toast to the 5 wonderful years of Opera Orlando.
And to many, many more. Thank you, Scott. Here we go.
Champagne is so majestic, tra-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, foreign and domestic, tra-da-da-da-da-da-da. It makes the world we live in a better place to live in. All good and jolly fellas should keep it in their cellars. We toast champagne, the essence of the essence, the king of effervescence, the king of effervescence. A toast, a toast, a toast. His Majesty, we celebrate, celebrate, long and late. Joyously together we toast champagne the great. We celebrate, celebrate, long and late. Joyously we drink to champagne the great. A toast to champagne the great.
Champagne's a delicious bubble from la-la-la-la-la-la. Scatter all our troubles from la-la-la-la-la-la. Adventures, world conditions, all diplomats and brothers should keep it in their quarters.